TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Thursday, the 27th of February. India's Prime Minister Modi, Myanmar President, hold talks in New Delhi. Pakistan confirms first two cases of coronavirus. And students in Nepal protest against tax hike on imported books. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi held talks with Myanmar President Win Myint in capital New Delhi on Thursday. 10 agreements were exchanged between the two countries aimed at strengthening bilateral ties. The Myanmar President is on a four-day India visit accompanied by First Lady.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday held talks with Myanmar President U Win Myint in capital New Delhi aimed at strengthening ties. Win Myint, who arrived on Wednesday, is on a four-day official visit to India accompanied by First Lady of Myanmar Daw Cho Cho. India and Myanmar exchanged 10 agreements, four of which focus on the construction of water supply systems, distribution of electricity by solar power, as well as construction of roads and schools in Myanmar's western Rakhine province. The other agreements call for cooperation in field of petroleum products, communication and health research. The deals were signed in presence of Prime Minister Modi and Myanmar's President at the Hyderabad House. Win Myint earlier in the day received a ceremonial welcome at the Presidential Palace. He also paid respects to Indian Freedom Movement leader Mahatma Gandhi by laying a wreath and offering flowers at his memorial Rajghat. President Myint and visiting dignitaries are slated to visit Eastern Bodh Gaya city and offer prayers at the Mahabodhi temple.
Heavy security continued to be deployed on Thursday as normalcy seemed to be returning in the Indian capital after days of violence over the new citizenship law.
Heavy security continued to be deployed on Thursday to prevent any untoward incidents, as normalcy seemed to have been returning after days of violence in the northeast part of Indian capital New Delhi. Residents expressed fear in the aftermath of the violent clashes over the Religion-Based Citizenship Amendment Act that have claimed more than 30 lives in the Indian capital. Shops in some areas of northeast Delhi, however, remained closed and people chose to stay indoors.
ठीक है दंगे फसाद तो ना हिंदू चाहते हैं ना मुसलमान but कुछ उपद्रवी है कुछ उपद्रवी कुछ मतलब कुछ तरह के लोग जो उपद्रवी हैं वो अफवाह फैला रहे हैं ठीक है वो कुछ दंगे फसाद करवाना चाह रहे हैं.
Delhi police also conducted flag marches in violence affected areas and assured people that the situation is normal and peaceful now. The police has so far registered 18 FIRs and 106 people have been arrested in connection with the violence.
तो ये मार्च हो रहा है ये हम जनता के दिल में एक विश्वास पैदा करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि अब उनको घबराने की जरूरत नहीं है अब उनको डरने की जरूरत नहीं है और पुलिस जो है जो भी इसमें कोई गलत काम करेगा उनके खिलाफ सख्त एक्शन लेगी.
Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal on Thursday announced a compensation of rupees 10 lakhs each to the deceased and free of cost medical treatment at any private hospital to the injured. Indian capital New Delhi has been the epicenter of unrest against the Citizenship Amendment Act, which makes it easier for non-Muslim communities from Afghanistan, Bangladesh and Pakistan to gain Indian citizenship, but does not include Muslims.
Special flights of the Indian Air Force and Air India arrived in capital New Delhi on Thursday after evacuating Indians and foreigners from coronavirus hit China's Wuhan city and quarantined cruise ship Diamond Princess in Japan. The new virus that originated in China has infected 82,000 globally and caused 2,800 deaths.
A special flight of Indian Air Force arrived in capital New Delhi on Thursday after evacuating Indians and foreigners from Chinese city of Wuhan, the epicenter of coronavirus outbreak. 76 Indians and 36 foreign nationals from seven countries, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Maldives, China, South Africa, USA and Madagascar were evacuated. All evacuees were taken to the paramilitary Indian-Tibetan Border Police quarantine facility in New Delhi's Chawla area after their thermal screening. The C-17 transport aircraft had earlier left for China with 15 tons of medical supplies from India to the virus-hit Wuhan. All the passengers will be kept at the facility for requisite quarantine period under observation of doctors.
Today, we have 112 passengers to take back. ये 76 इसमें भारतीय हैं और 36 नेशनल्स हैं जो बांग्लादेश म्यांमार मालदीव्स चाइना साउथ अफ्रीका यूएसए और मडागास्कर के हैं.
An Air India flight on Thursday also brought 119 Indians and 5 foreigners to New Delhi, who were on board quarantine Diamond Princess cruise ship docked off Yokohama in Japan. India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar in a tweet informed that 5 foreign nationals are from Sri Lanka, Nepal, South Africa and Peru. The evacuees will undergo a 14-day quarantine at a medical facility set up by the Indian Army in northern Manesar town. Meanwhile, out of the total 138 Indian nationals originally on board the Diamond Princess, 16 Indian crew members who have tested positive for virus are receiving necessary medical care and treatment at onshore medical facilities in Japan.
Pakistan has confirmed its first 2 cases of the novel coronavirus days after Islamabad closed its land border with Iran, where 19 people have died from the virus. The government has assured the public that there was no need to panic.
Pakistan on Wednesday confirmed its first 2 cases of coronavirus in patients who had recently travelled to Iran, officials said. One of the patients who tested positive in Pakistan's largest city, Karachi, had spent 3 days in the Iran along with a group of 28 pilgrims before returning on February 20, a provincial official said. Pakistan's Health Minister Zafar Mirza took to Twitter and assured the public that there was no need to panic but be careful and act responsibly.
In dono logon ki history mein haliya dinon mein Iran ka safar paya gaya hai. Dono ka link Iran ke mein journey ke sath hai pichle taqreeban 14 din ke andar andar. Main yahan pe ये जरूरी समझता हूं कि पाकिस्तान के लोगों को ये बताऊं कि इस पे हमारा रिएक्शन क्या होना चाहिए. तो अर्ज ये है कि हमें ना तो किसी किस्म की बिला जरूरत परेशानी में जाना चाहिए, किसी किस्म का पैनिक क्रिएट नहीं करना चाहिए.
पाकिस्तान क्लोज इट्स बॉर्डर विद ईरान ऑन संडे फॉलोइंग द कोरोना वायरस आउटब्रेक इन अ नेबरिंग कंट्री इन व्हिच 19 पीपल हैव डाइड एंड 139 हैव बीन इन्फेक्टेड. मोर देन 200 पाकिस्तानी शियाइट मुस्लिम पिलग्रिम्स आर बीइंग केप्ट इन अ मेकशिफ्ट क्वारंटाइन फैसिलिटी एट द बॉर्डर.
मोर न्यूज़ फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान. The remains of a teenager were found in the lion enclosure at an animal park in Pakistan's Lahore city on Wednesday. The 18-year-old had gone missing 2 days earlier.
The remains of a Pakistani teenager who had been missing for 2 days were found in the lion's enclosure at a zoo in Lahore city. The skull and bones of 18-year-old Muhammad Bilal were discovered when staff at a safari park went to feed the animals on Wednesday. Officials said they are investigating how Bilal made it over the fence and what caused his death.
Inshallah, is pe jo bhi ho sakta hoga us pe action lenge. Police bhi investigation kar rahi hai. Jaise hi koi cheez hamare samne aati hai, fir media ke sath share ki jayegi.
Bilal's family later on Wednesday ransacked parts of the zoo to protest at what they said was incompetence, but park authorities, police said. The state-backed Lahore Safari Park was established in 1982 and is Pakistan's largest and oldest animal park.
News from Nepal. Students in Nepal's Lalitpur city have been protesting over tax hike on imported books in a unique way by holding discussions over educational topics and reciting poetry.
Disgruntled students in Nepal's Lalitpur city have initiated a unique protest against the government's order of levying additional taxes on imported books by just holding regular discussions over various educational topics. The protesters gather at the Patan Darbar Square in the city every evening to discuss various topics related to books whose supplies have been halted following the government order.
We thought to make some kind of creative protest against the government. And actually we have been just saying this kind of thing, like people cursing and shouting against the government. So we just began to think what could be the creative option against this kind of thing. And as a result, we just came to the concept like book discussion, reciting poems and so on.
Last year, the Nepal government passed the order of levying an additional 10% tax on imported books. Following the order, the supply of books have been halted and students say they face hardships in their studies. Nepal has been importing over 80% of its books from India.
Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa and Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa earlier this week officially opened an extension to the country's southern expressway that would link a crucial seaport and international airport to capital Colombo.
Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa and Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa earlier this week officially opened an extension to the country's southern expressway that would link the country's main ports and airports. The ribbon-cutting ceremony was attended by the President and Prime Minister as well as the Chinese ambassador to Sri Lanka. Both the Sri Lankan leaders later travelled on the southern expressway after the inauguration and President Gotabaya paid the first toll fee. The main objective of the project is to connect the Hambantota Harbour and Matala International Airport to Sri Lankan capital Colombo. It is expected to bring about greater economic and social development with tourism as the main focus. Construction of the extension, which began in 2015, was undertaken by three Chinese contractors. It stretches from Godagama in the southern Matara district to Matala in the southeastern Hambantota district.
With the Festival of Colors, Holi, just around the corner, people in India's northern Uttar Pradesh province are ringing in the festivities with celebratory music, food and cheer. The spring festival signifies the triumph of good over evil. It also celebrates the eternal love of Lord Krishna and his consort Radha.
Locals as well as tourists in Mathura city of India's northern Uttar Pradesh province are ringing in the festivities of Holi, the festival of colours. A large number of people were seen smearing each other with colours at the famous Dwarkadish temple on Wednesday as they celebrated Pulera Dooj to mark the arrival of Holi. Devotees also sang hymns for Hindu Lord Krishna and danced to the beats of traditional instruments. Mathura, Nandgaon, Aligarh and other parts in the region of Brij are considered to be the land of Lord Krishna in India, and Holi is celebrated with special fervour in this region throughout a week prior to the actual festival. The festival of Holi is an occasion to meet, forget and forgive and repair broken relationships. Holi falls on March 10th this year.
Well, that's the wait within South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. India's Prime Minister Modi, Myanmar President hold talks in New Delhi. Pakistan confirms first two cases of coronavirus. And students in Nepal protest against tax hike on imported books. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.